Good morning, Dr. Yi again, and here we are continuing this series of videos on canine herpes virus. So I'm sure you know that this virus name is on everyone's lips when it comes to canine reproduction. And today, we are going to discuss what you must know about those specific viruses, because herpes viruses in general are very unique. So watch this video and you'll find out what I mean here.
Why is the frequency of infection so important? Why are so many animals, why so many animals have been exposed to herpes virus? Because herpes viruses have something special. Most of the time, you know, when we deal with a viral infection, our body will mount an immune response and somehow get rid of the virus. But in the case of herpes virus, they have a special ability which is called latency. The herpes virus, when the immune system tries to kick it out of the organism, the herpes viruses will go and hide in a certain location, very frequently in a place called the trigeminal ganglion in the brain, and it will stay there, hiding from the immune system. So in fact, and when they're here, they cannot be reached by the immune system, which means one thing: an individual which has been infected by herpes is typically infected for life. It will be very, very rare that somebody can get rid of herpes virus infection. When you're infected for life. And we will see that there are times when this virus can reactivate, and this is when eventually it can cause an issue. But that explains you why it is so frequent to see dogs positive for herpes virus, because of this specific phenomenon where the virus hides in a very specific location. One thing we know about herpes, if we find a positive result, it doesn't tell us if the bitch was able to get rid of the disease. As I said, when they are infected for life. So in this case, there's a phenomenon called reactivation we need to be aware of. When a bitch is positive for herpes, the virus can be reactivated at any time. And when it's reactivated, this is when she will start shedding the virus and potentially be able to contaminate other individuals. The problem is that we are not really sure when this reactivation period will occur. Well, not exactly true. We know that typically this occurs when the immune system is depressed. In breeding females, this typically occurs during estrus or during gestation. So this is when you can potentially have a reactivation. So remember, Victoria, she was outside of her breeding season. She was not in heat when we saw her. So if we were testing her there, we have several tests that we can use. Typically, in adult bitches, we will do what we call a serology. We draw blood and we look for the antibodies. But if we test her at this time, I mean, maybe if she comes back negative, it doesn't tell us anything. It just tells us that at this moment, she is not shedding herpes virus. And that's all we know. We won't be able to we won't know if she's infected or not. Same thing, a positive test will just tell you that she has been exposed to herpes. So she's probably infected and she will probably be infected for all her life. But it doesn't tell us if currently she's shedding the virus. So very important to understand the limitation of those tests. And